Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission at hand is Blackjack, which is to locate and defuse a terrorist bomb. Now, I don't know how difficult this mission is going to be because it seems pretty arbitrary. Knowing Delta Force, it probably is going to be difficult, but it may also be easy. Who knows? I wonder what sort of enemy resistance we are to face in this mission, if at all, or if it's just going to be about, you know, roaming the map aimlessly until you finally get to a bomb. Maybe there would be, you know, enemies guarding it, who knows. Let's see. Whoa, that's a lot of enemies. Mission: locate and retrieve a terrorist bomb located near a village designated objective Lee. Your insertion point is approximately 430 meters northeast of the enemy-occupied village. Proceed through your checkpoints, eliminating any enemy units you encounter. Once you have penetrated the village, search it for the bomb. When you have located the bomb, defuse it and then proceed immediately to your extraction point. Success of this mission depends on you finding the terrorist bomb. Okay. Expected enemy force. According to the analysis of information from the captured computer, a force between 10 and 22 troops would normally be used to hold a village this size. Special reconnaissance conducted in preparation for this mission indicates another 10 to 20 men have been moved into the village in order to secure the perimeter while the bomb is being readied. So, basically 40 people. There is no indication of any heavy weapons or air support available to the forces within the village at this time. Jeta believes the bomb has been set in or near the temple ruins near the village. Now, one question I have at this point is, if this is an enemy-controlled village, why are we bothering with defusing the bomb at all? I mean, if they're going to explode the bomb, doesn't it sort of harm them? Or maybe they're planning on, you know, transporting the bomb elsewhere, perhaps. So yeah, it might be, you know, a threat when transported elsewhere to blow some other person up or blow some other target up. At any rate, Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted approximately 870 meters southeast of the objective. They will proceed northwest into the village and suppress any resistance along that flank. Charlie team will be inserted approximately 770 meters south of the village. They are tasked with suppressing enemy perimeter defenses along the terrorist's southern flank. So basically Alpha team is somewhere over here, and basically Charlie team would be somewhere over here, and both of them have just one objective: enter and take out the enemies from this side. So I guess that leaves us with these enemies. Actually, that leaves us with all of these enemies, because since it's Delta Force, our friends can't exactly take care of shit. Excuse me. For my French. Pardon my French. Situation. In retaliation for the destruction of their command and training bases, the terrorists have vowed to use their biological weapons against an unsuspecting target. Okay. The terrorists have recently forced the people of a small village north of the city of Samarinda to vacate their homes. A special reconnaissance team observing the disposition of IMT forces at that village has noted a recent increase in activity at the statues and ruins near the village. They have also noted several indications that the IMT forces are preparing to withdraw from the village and invite its former occupants back. I see. So I guess that's why we need to go ahead and defuse the bomb and the situation before it gets any worse. J2 believes that the IMT plans on setting a bomb in the ruins and then setting it off once they have withdrawn and the villagers have returned. This cannot be allowed to occur. Now, if it is something that is contagious and, you know, slow developing, then of course it might lead to a bigger pandemic. Not unlike the COVID-19. So yeah, M4, Spec Ops 45, double load ammo, that is exactly the loadout I was looking for in this game. Sorry, for this mission at least. Let's go ahead and start it then. I got shot by somebody from across the pond. Yeah, so there are some people over here as well that we want to tackle. I wonder if how much damage we can do with a single shot.
Alpha, ready to move in.
That probably conserves a lot of bullets as well, doesn't it? Hmm. That actually does contain a lot of bullets. That guy's dead.
This is Charlie. We're moving in.
Roger Charlie, Godspeed. Roger Alpha, Godspeed. Anyway, let me just go ahead and kill the rest of these people here who are coming to shoot me. Dead. I've been trying this mission for quite a few times now. I think this is attempt number 18, if not 19. And yeah, needless to say, I've been unsuccessful in every single attempt. Which is quite unfortunate, but I would like to say it is what it is, and leave it at that. Anybody else? I saw a few people running there, but that might have been just glitches.
I can
see a person there. I can see another person there. It doesn't take too many bullets to neutralize enemies in this game. It only takes like one bullet.
We have heavy perimeter defense.
I can see that. What do you think I've been dealing with all this far? Enemies. Now I thought I saw another enemy on top of the hill here.
Alpha 1 is down!
Are you sure I'm on you passing Alpha 1? Charlie 1 and 2, hopefully you shall remain alive. Now, you can see the problem with this map, it's that there are way too many enemies just swarming you at any given point in time. And the safest course of action for you is to...
Charlie 1 is down!
You shall be missed, Charlie 1. I hope. I hope you have somebody at home to miss you. Because otherwise your life is pretty much, you know, has amounted to nothing thus far. I hear somebody coming up. This way. I like how these people sometimes take their time, you know, sitting down to aim at you. And, well, basically I like how they take their time aiming at you. It gives us time to kill them. And that's just one of the ways that this game becomes easier than it actually is. Like, just take a look at these guys. There are some people on top ahead of me as well, like above me, and I sort of want them to come to me instead of me going to them, like that guy over there. He had ample opportunity to shoot me but chose not to, for whatever reason, which was convenient to him. Sometimes even the cursor in these games doesn't make sense because I can have my crosshairs right on the enemy, but it will not actually shoot the enemy, but shoot like a random person instead. Now, I can't see some shots being fired at me, I just don't understand from where. And it is at this point that I must exercise a little bit of caution, or regret, you know, dying. More people coming my way, let me just... return to my position on top of this hill here. It seems like a nice pivot point for me to deal with multiple enemies. That guy died. And there's another person over here.
Doctor.
No, you should not get a doctor, you've been a bad boy. I thought I saw a shot come from up here. Ah, there, I see. Anybody else? At any rate, we should probably get a move on and attempt to, you know, actually tackle the objective, tackle the target, accomplish the objective that we were sent here to accomplish. So, yeah, it would seem that as far as this area is concerned, most of the people have been killed. And I actually checked killed everybody on the map, even Charlie, one or two, either of them was alive back then. And I really attempted to... pretty much, you know, like, I had started, looking around for the bomb, but I just couldn't find it, and there's a certain building, where it's sort of, Excuse me, I've got a cough going on. I believe I've been repeating that for the past few videos, and the cough has not been getting any better, has it? Maybe I should get it checked out. At any rate, I don't see any more people here, just some people stuck on top of... well... stuff. Shooting two rounds into the air to make it, you know, even for a 3-round burst. At any rate, let's go ahead and... this is the area from which assaulting this enemy base becomes far easier compared to other places. So yeah, I like to stick to this side and keep moving. There's Alpha another person, probably Alpha 2. Alpha team shall be missed. My condolences, Alpha team. I hope that your untimely passing shall bring solace to a lot
this
of people.
King 6. Bravo, find that target. You don't have much time.
Roger King 6, this is Bravo attempting to find the target. And I have attempted to find the target before this, and it has always been like a huge challenge. I've searched that. I have, actually haven't. Wait, this. That's the bomb. You have to be kidding me. No way. That's the bomb. That tiny little thing was the bomb. I was expecting it to be much larger. What's that gonna do? Take care of this pillar? Anyway, let's just end this mission, since we have the chance to do it. 44 kills, and despite all of that, all of those bodies that are laid out on my own, the 44 bodies, there were at least 10 more people inside that village. So the intelligence given to us was clearly wrong. There were anywhere close to 55 or even 60 enemies on base at the, inside, like in this mission. So anyway. Congratulations, Bravo team. Quick location and recovery of the objective saved the lives of many innocents who could have been hurt or killed by the terrorists. After a thorough examination of the bomb and tracking the paths of the paths that it was built from, J2 has identified two suspected IMT terrorists who built the bomb. Indonesian Army Intelligence has informed the JSOC that those men are currently believed to be at an IMT base near the city of Kundavangan. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce that, of course. Neutralization of their base is now on Bravo team's schedule. Ooh, so there are actually 7 missions in this campaign. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, there are apparently 7 missions in this campaign, might even be 8 missions in total. So yeah, pacify all enemy forces at a terrorist base, designated objective Eden, that is shut down, and lockdown. Capture the commander of terrorist base, designated objective Wu. Now this seems more like a finale sort of mission. So what I am gonna do is, I'm gonna address Operation Shutdown first. And I'll leave that for the next time we come over. And yeah, thank you for tuning in for Blackjack. It has been a pain in the ass for me to play, to say the least. Pretty frustrating, had to like retry again and again. And yeah, not all of it was my fault. There have been times where I've been successful as well, but the game decided to just bug out and made me redo it all over again. So yeah, anyhow, I digress. Thank you for watching. When we come back next time, we'll cover Shutdown. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings. It's time for me to shut this recording down.